Hello, in this video we are going to solve two prominent issues which we generally face. The very first one being that whenever we write something in our cells, we all the time have to auto-fit the columns so that the columns width get adjusted and we have the entire content visible. Like over here we have first name, but the name has been hidden. Exactly if I type anything over here, suppose I type just a normal thing. Suppose I write address, okay? So you can see the size may not match accurately, or let me just write something as complete address. So these are the cells which are not fitting, these are the words which are not completely fitting in your column. So you need to all the time auto fit this, right? So how we can use just one line of code in our VBA so that this entire issue is solved, and wherever you type in your columns, anywhere in your cell, it automatically adjusts, the column size automatically adjusts itself. Okay, so moving on, I'll go to my developer over here and I'll go to the Visual Basic, or you can use the shortcut Alt F11. So I'll use the shortcut Alt F11. This is what opens up. I will double click on sheet 2 because you can see this is my sheet 2, which is auto fit and save. So I'll just double click on this. Double clicking on this will give me a coding screen. After this, you just need to click on the worksheet over here. Once you click on the worksheet, you'll get something as worksheet selection change event. So just you need to change the event. How to change this event? You just have to click on this particular drop down and just select change. The moment you select this, you have worksheet change event. I do not need this, so I can delete the sub. Moving on, this is the place where I will write my code. So you can see it says private sub, end sub. So anything which you write in your worksheet is a private sub, and the difference between the two has been explained in my other video. So over here I'll just make a small one-liner code which will adjust all my column size in the sheet 2 only. So what I'll do, I'll write cells dot entire column, and you can see I get this IntelliSense. This is called the IntelliSense. To select entire column, you do not have to write, you do not have to type it down. You can just click on tab, or you can click on dot, and it fills up, it auto fills. You do not have to type it down. And then we'll write auto fit, and see, you get auto fit as well. And I'll just again click on tab. This is how you give your first liner code, which is one liner code, which is cells. Cells meaning it will select all the cells in your worksheet. Entire column means all the columns, and it will dot auto fit all the columns. And this is there in your change event. Now I'll just give you a quick review as to what, quick summary as to what a change event is. A change event is basically when you make any changes in your worksheet, be it a small calculation, be it deleting something, be it adding something, be it writing something, anything you do is a change event. So what it will do, that it will trigger this particular macro, and when it triggers this macro, it will run this entire code. And the moment it runs this code, what you'll do, what it will get, what will be the output, all your columns will be auto-fitted itself. So moving on, I'll just make a small change in this worksheet. So let me just give a new column heading over here, and the new column heading can be simply age. I have just written age, and I'll click on enter, and you can see all the columns have been auto-fitted. Again, I'll show you all one more example. So let me just write and see, it auto fits. So this is how you can solve this issue just by passing one liner code. The next issue which we generally face is that we generally forget to save our work, and we simply close down our workbook. If you are reusing, or you are again using this workbook the next time and you forget to save, and you just click on the cross button just like that, and when you get the dialog box, do you want to save your work, and by mistake you click on the no, then you lose all your work just in one go. So how to avoid those issues is, again, we'll pass one more code, just a small code, and we'll get our VB editor, Alt F11. Now this time we are talking about the entire workbook. So my concern is for the entire workbook, not for a particular sheet. So what I'll do is, I'll just click on this workbook. The moment I click on this workbook, again I get a coding screen. Now this coding screen is basically for this entire workbook which is here, and this is the name. I have not renamed it, so it says new Microsoft Excel worksheet, and this code which I write over here will be affected to the entire workbook. Again over here I will select workbook, and by default you get an open event. Open event basically says when you open your workbook, this will be the macro which will be triggered. But now I want a close event, because when you close your workbook, you need to save whatever work you have done. So it's a close event which you want to trigger. So I'll just click on the drop down over here, and we'll get the before close event. So what it says, that before closing your workbook, you have to save whatever you have done. Again, it says the same thing. You have to write your code between the private sub and the end sub. And then whenever this event is triggered, and how will this event be triggered? When you click on this cross button over here and you simply want to close your workbook, so just before closing your workbook, this event will be triggered and it will save your entire work. To save your entire work, we just pass a one liner code which says active workbook. So I'll write active workbook. See, how do you get this entire thing? You click on control space, that is an IntelliSense prompt we'll talk about in other classes. So you get the entire workbook, active workbook. You do not have to type everything. I'll show you all again. You just have to write active and work, and then you can just simply click on control space. Control space will give you everything. Active workbook. This is the IntelliSense prompt which we say in VBA language. Okay, and then we just write save. See, you have save. You also have save as. We'll cover save as in our in some other class, where we see that how we can manipulate save as. If we always want to save our work according to a particular name and a particular format, so that can also be done. For the timing, we'll just use active workbook.save. This is just like clicking on control S, and whenever you forget to save, or maybe you just click on the no button on that dialog box which you get when you close a workbook. So this thing will avoid that, and you will save your work. To make it more interesting, I will show you all that how you get a message box each time you close this workbook. So let me just give a message box to the user saying that you are closing your workbook, right? So we'll say bye bye. So this will be triggered when you close this workbook. It will automatically save it and it'll give you a dialog box saying bye bye. Okay, let me just see this, what happens. I'll just minimize this and try to click on the cross button over here. Okay, and you get a bye bye over here. So this is how simply it works, and you can simply auto fit all your columns which you have just by passing one code, and also you can save your workbook without typing control S all the time, or getting that window box which you get once you click on the cross button. You close button, you get that dialog box asking you whether you want to save the work or not. Or you, when you want to give the user a message box while exiting the workbook, that can also be done, as we saw in this case. Also, if you want to give a message box when the user opens a workbook, then you know that you just need to pass a comment in your, as we did here, we passed the comment in our before close event. You need to pass the comment in your open event. Thank you. This is it for this class.